Mona. Looking good.
Max, we gotta stop meeting like this.
It will be a cold day in hell before I let a narc cop stop me. Miss Sachs, do your job.
Relax, Max. You're a nice guy. I don't kill nice guys.
You're not bad yourself.
It was different when Horn wanted Punchinello dead, to cut her ties to the Mafia. He deserved to die.
The same goes with her. She's the bad guy here. Her sister was whispering to her in my favor. I knew the appetites of ghosts intimately. They hungered for revenge.
Max!
No!
A gunshot boomed and she fell down in slow motion. She was a nice girl, not really a stone-cold killer. And now she was stone-cold dead. Like religious fanatics or loyal samurai, Horn's private army was coming at me.
Max Payne located.
When the elevator came back down, Mona was gone. There was a lot of blood, but no body. Something clicked for the final time. My mind had never been so clear, as if somewhere high above the storm clouds were already gone, cold stars blazing from the black skies.
And I'm talking about the coolest of the cool. It always seems like time slows down in the middle of the action. You know, you can see the bullets flying through the air, the hero dodging in slow motion. Oh man, it would be so cool to be able to do that. Bullet time, that's what they call it. Bullet time, yeah, would be so cool.
What the?
Movies, and I'm talking about the coolest of the cool. It always seems like
we'll be right back.
I had elevator access to the mainframe. From there, I'd be able to override the security locks and get to her office. The unmarked chopper was Horn's pet guardian, inhuman and flawless. It was stalking me.
I hate to be stereotyped. I'm not a cold-blooded killer. I'm a nice guy. I love my wife. I have two boys I'm very proud of. You just have to make the ends meet. And if that means I have to shoot someone now and then, hey, it's just my job from 9 to 5.
Well, not quite from 9 to 5, but I hear you.
Kill the bastard!
locks were now offline. All bets were off. The elevator would take me all the way up. Seen from this height, the night seemed to stretch on to eternity. A hint of desperation had crept into the snowstorm, as if it was trying to get it all out before the end. Horn's personal computer was on. Next to the printer was a neat stack of expensive paper. Hacking through Horn's computer would have unearthed files of criminal plans, strategies for world domination, spy helicopter reports, illegal wiretap recordings, internet porno, all of the above. Take your pick. I really didn't care anymore. I had seen too much of it already.